Hi, I am Yasmin Vera with Academic Technology and Creative Services. Welcome to this SacCT tutorial where I will show you how to add basic content to a course. First, we will review a sample content area, which is a location that will house your files and folders. Next, we will add our basic content, which includes folders, files, and items. The first step in adding content to a course is to select an existing content area in your course or create a new one. Content areas are essentially pages that organize and display content, such as folders, files, web links, and links to course tools. Content areas can be accessed and created from the course menu. Here is a new course in SacCT. By default, a new course will have one or more content areas already set up. These default content areas are labeled Content and Information. Other courses may have this content area labeled differently, such as Content Area, Course Materials, for example. If a content area is not available in your course menu, you can create a new one by clicking the Add icon plus sign on the course menu. Select the Content Area option from the drop-down menu, then enter a name for the Content Area link that will display on the course menu. Check the box next to Available to Users to make this area visible to students, and click Submit. Now we are ready to add some content into our selected content area. Click on the Content Area link on the course menu to open it. We recommend that you begin by adding a folder to group related content and keep it organized. Let's add a folder. Select the Build Content option from the action bar to review a drop-down list of options. Then click the Content Folder option. From the Create Content Folder page, type in a descriptive name for your folder. In the text box, type in a description and/or additional information about the type of content students may find in the folder. Next, under the Standard Options section, notice the default option for Permit Users to View This Content is already set to Yes, meaning the folder will be visible to users. If needed, select a display after and display until date and time if you plan to make the folder available for a specific time period. Click Submit to save and add the folder. Now that we have added a folder, we can begin adding files. Files such as Word and PDF documents, PowerPoint presentations, Excel files can be added to a content area using the File or Item options from the Build Content menu. Select File to add a single file, no description, or select Item to add one or more files, text, and other elements like graphics, audio, or video. Let's use the File option first to add a PowerPoint file into our Week 1 folder. First, click on the folder name to open it. Next, select the Build Content option from the action bar to reveal a drop-down list of options. Then click File. The Create File screen will display. From the Select Files section, type in a descriptive name for the file which will become the link's name. From the Find File area, click Browse My Computer and locate the file. Upon selecting the file, notice that the file name and type now display. From the File Options section, you may change the Open in a New Window setting. By default, it is set to No, meaning that the file will open within the SacCT course. Under the Standard Options section, choose Settings for Availability, Tracking Statistics, and Date and Time Restrictions for the file. By default, the Permit Users to View This Content setting is set to Yes, meaning the file will be visible to students. If you're finished, click Submit to save and add the file. A new link to the PowerPoint labeled Chapter 1 Lecture Slides now displays in the folder. You can test your file link immediately. Simply click on the text link to open it. Now let's add two related articles using the item option. An item can combine various elements such as text, links to multiple files, web resources, images, video, and audio. Thus, you can use an item to group related files or use it to provide a description or introduction in a folder or content area. First, select the Build Content option from the action bar to reveal a drop-down list of options. Then, click Item. The Create Item page will display. In the Content Information section, type in a name that describes the item. In the text box, type in a description and/or additional information you want the item to display on the page. You can use the text editor options to format text, add a link to a website, add links to video and/or audio. In the Attachments section, you can attach one or more files using the Browse My Computer or Browse Content Collection options. Click Browse My Computer to search for a file from your computer. Upon selecting the files, these will display in the Attached Files area. Optionally, you can edit the link title to provide a more descriptive name for each attached file. Unlike the folder and file options in the Standard Options section, the default setting is already set to Yes to allow users to view the item. Select other options, such as tracking and date and time restrictions if needed. Click Submit to save and add your item. The new item labeled Chapter 1 Readings is now displaying in the folder. Notice the item is not clickable. Only the attached files are clickable and can be opened by clicking on the respective names. Like files, you can immediately preview the attached files from your item. Simply click on their name. We have finished adding some basic content to a course content area, which included a folder, a file, and an item. Let's recap the steps. First, add or select an existing content area in your course. This will be the location where you will add content. Then, begin by adding folders to keep content organized. You can label folders by week, unit, or topic. And finally, add files to your course using the File or Item option. Add files such as lecture handouts, slides, readings, etc. to corresponding folders using the File or Item options. If you still need help or have questions, contact us by phone, email, or visit our website. Thank you for watching.